goes beyond the 13 members of the executive. It goes beyond the president and his vice presidents and the members of the executive. That is why, during such a critical moment, we found it very important to invite our members, the 32 members, to come, attend, listen, appreciate, and we forge a way forward together. FUFA has also offered to facilitate a meeting either in Zurich or Kampala between the Solicitor General, NCS, FUFA legal team, and FIFA legal to get a common position and opinion on the matters. All documents for registration, all documentation for registration was handed over to the National Council of Sports. However, one area remains a concern, that is registration of FIFA under trusteeship, on which FIFA and Solicitor General have different legal opinions. The point of diversion is that whereas FIFA and FUFA respect national laws, the current regulations have been drawn to violate FIFA statutes. They make government interference legal, although inconsistent with the current NCS Act. Current status. FUFA has reported reports, especially from both the print and electronic media, that the NCS is planning to dissolve federations that have not complied with the regulations, including FUFA. Yet we have noted that federations that have been cleared by the NCS do not meet most of the requirements of the regulations. FUFA has met today and called on all its 32 members to remain focused on football activities and give support to the Uganda Cranes 2017 AFCON qualification campaign, with two matches coming up against Botswana, Comoros, and AFCON under 20 against Egypt. FUFA has written to the Right Honourable Prime Minister Dr. Hakainde Hichilema for indulgence in this matter. FUFA is still awaiting response from National Council of Sports on our roadmap